And 28 to authority, 15 to 16. Verse 9.
Here, verse 4, verse
27, verse we are talking about. You are cursed, lickers. For ye have.
For ye have what?
You are cursed, lickers. For you have loved me. Even this woman, this. This is the only verse that is connected with Judgment 28, 15 to 16, and also our church. And many did not give notice to this or give importance to this verse. Because they thought they are not very important. They are very important. And one of the sins of the church is that they seek their souls. That's why they are in poverty. Is that these are insignificant now because they are all pestilent. Do you believe that? What if they are in the Old Testament? If there is something there that concerns your blessing, you better listen to this. There are things in the Old Testament that are relevant. There are things that are relevant. I can show you some relevant things in the Old Testament. Like there's some new lessons. And God commanded Noah to build the ark to fulfill the word of God in Genesis. But it is irrelevant. It is a story that is already passed and done. But as an offering, because we still need blessing today, we need blessing today. So much to leave. You need financial blessing. Because you need financial blessing, you have to obey. And you have to take heed. You have to give importance to this. I always hope I stay because I am a professor. Because those are fulfilled in my life. I am the first one who gave so much importance to this. But when I was under training, I did not only give my hands, I said, Father, I will give the 19, I will give the 10. So he put me in this place because he is the Lord who makes me there. That's what he gave me, a Lord. Today, this place has a son in the position of the son. Now, my honor. I gave so much importance to this commandment that I said, Father, I will not only give 10, I'll give you the 90. That is how I give importance to this. That's why he made me his son and he delivered to me the world. Because he can trust me. Because he can trust me. Hallelujah. And people did not give so much importance to this. That is very important. Have you heard how long the curses, the promise of curses are if you disobey? That's why in the kingdom we are so thankful to God who has guided us. And we are so thankful he gave us the greatest gift in the benefit he has given us. It's a spirit of obedience to his will that is now our spirit and that is now our life. It is now within us. And we go to God, the Father has blessed us. First, the spiritual blessings of taking away the serpent's sin. So, our relationship with the serpent's sin and Lucifer the devil is broken. He cannot own us anymore, and he cannot take ownership of us anymore. When he sees us in the spirit, he will not be able to say, those are my children. Oh, they are worshiping, but they are my children. Those in the church days, and in the church days, they will worship. But Satan, Lucifer, the devil, will not allow him but they are not. We are the Sunday and told them the truth. He's all around their father. He's the devil. Instead of us that he looks at and try to introspect even himself to say that we believe in what he said. They cannot accept that because they are fully defined. It's even during the reception, they crucify the one who should have opened their eyes to the truth of the spiritual situation we are in. Today, I am so grateful that all of you did not crucify me, but you accepted the words of the Almighty Father through His appointed Son. Your eyes are open to the truth. Now, it's not found in the Old Testament, but because they are the subjects of blessings and the Father would like to bless us through even while we are here. How may God bless us if we do not believe in this? How will He if we cannot be trusted, if we cannot be trusted in even giving what is not ours? He was only asking for 10% of everything he has to honor him and to recognize him that he is the creator of all. He is the creator of everything that sustains life. That makes us healthy and wealthy. He was the one who created the air of beings. And he created. He created the sunlight that gives you vitamin D that let our plant grow. That gives nutrients to the soil. He was the one who created the atmosphere. He was the one who created the rain. Everything is for free. He was even the one who created you. He owns your life. Your life came from Him. And the devil doesn't want us to recognize that by just moving through it. And when you are now God like Him, you can decide. Forget about Him. He cannot touch you because you are God like Him. You can decide to be all of this true. When man decides to leave God alone, and when man decides to even curse God, and when man decides to even not believe in God like the atheists and the agnostics, and the unbelievers, the Father will then send a lightning to strike them down to prove that He is still in power and in authority. You see that? You know why? Because He is the history of sooner or later, you will die. You will end your physical life. Sooner or later, you will face injustice. And that is when you get the shackles of that view. Man's constitutional man is trying to cover it with the pride of life that he has in his life. Don't want to recognize the Almighty. Just want to recognize the light that is something in him, especially if you're intelligent, is especially in him, but you have the wisdom of this world, and you are known, and his grace in this world, and you forget about him, and you make a man out of yourself. That's why I am beautiful. Many, many titles after my name. I don't want you to worship the titles. They are nothing in the sight of the Father. If the titles don't recognize the spiritual work the Father has done on this earth, those titles will not save you. Don't talk of divinity titles will not save you. Master of philosophy titles will not save you. Your master's degrees, your doctorate degrees, your postgraduate degrees are nothing. When you die, all you have is a name. What's her name? One of the destiny. Because when you were born, you were destined a name. You don't see that your mother and father will give you a name. The spirit of father will recognize that name. But in the sight of the father, you are just man and woman. Amen. It's not important in the sense of a woman. Amen. A woman. He might not even call out your name, because your name is only given to you by your parents. By the first year of argument, probably he will recognize that name. But for a few matter woman in the sense of argument. And your only problem is not even your name. Your only problem is spiritual. Did you repent? Did you listen to my voice or not? Did you listen to the voice of my holy son? If you obey my way, those are the things that will be the sons of Israel. Do not use your Christian because they will not be recognized. Do not use your religious credentials because they will not be recognized. Do not even use your positions of prophets or apostles. The Bible doesn't care about that. He doesn't care about that. Probably those that doesn't complain in front of the Father are apostles and prophets. Love the enemy. How can you promise I will do it with the promise? How can you have some demons when you are not an apostle? There are so many apostles in the world today that call themselves apostles because they are apostles and they are prophets. They prophesy and they cast out demons. These are the same people who will complain in the sight of the Father using both the reasons, religious reasons, or their salvation. They will give their salvation because of those religious reasons. I'm born again in the spirit. He's supporting you. I'm supporting the mission of Jesus. You are not one of the children. You are full of the service. And Satan is a good deliverer. Who is already up to something to take on fire will be there. Something at you.
Hey, I know you.
Come in.
You're my son.
You cannot deny your father. As you call Jesus and said, he is not the son of God. The devil is not the son of God. See, this is a reality. The kingdom of heaven is already here today. It's a reality.
The way they treat the Christ, the way they mistreat the son, even in Jesus. The way you treat the kingdom here in timing or not coming is the way you will be treated when judgment will come.
He will not be charged with the things you don't know. He will only be charged with the things you know. So if you do not accept the Son whom you can see right now, how can you accept the Father whom you cannot see? How can you come into the kingdom? Now, in the kingdom there is no religion. No race, no culture. You are not born here by your race. Are you born here by your race? Are you in the privilege that you are born here by your tribe? Or you are naive, you are prophetic, or you are born before the Lord? You are the God of the Lord to the right. You are the one of the Lord. We don't preach to you by your race. We don't ask you any religion. We don't ask you anything. But there is only one thing we all have to do.
Repent. So that we
are. We are not the enemy. That is the connection of the enemy in your life.
That's why you became a child of the devil, because of that spirit. And that is the enemy's remedy. If you want to surrender God, then you will handle yourself. Then the Father will feed you and have mercy on you and give you a new spirit. Spirit to be just to speak. So this is very important. The mercy of the spirit is as the law. They are printed with Malachi 3:7-9. God promises of mercy this day waters in love. All things. We don't be talking about the word. We don't be reminiscing later. Okay, the revolution is not necessarily being a secret verse. The kingdom of God and his righteousness is not. That's the revolution. Spiritual revolution and financial revolution for Islam, and they are interpreted in Matthew 6 and 18 verses. That's the whole thing of financial and spiritual revolution. Spiritual revolution is simply verse in the kingdom of God and his righteousness. If you go into the kingdom of God, what do you do? If you see the kingdom of God first, what do you do? You find it. It's when you feel the sun. And the first message is feel from the sun is repent. Surrender. Repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent for the kingdom of God is here. Wow! My brothers and sisters, just give him one big hand of offering. Woo! Hallelujah! May the Father bless you, may be seated. The first sign that you have already seen in entering into the kingdom of God is when you already have repented. When you have repented and say, Father, not my will, but your will be done.
That is a sign that the kingdom of God is now on you. If we pray the prayer, our Father, then this is your 96% night. After this card, therefore, praying, our Father, which are in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
What is the sign that the kingdom of God has come?
Present the kingdom come and will be done in earth.
I will be done on earth. On earth. On earth. On earth. Everybody says, I will be done on earth. It is done in heaven. In heaven, there's no problem doing the will of the Father. It's not a problem is here because the people who are physically alive are all full of discrepancy. And who can do the will of the Father? That's why the kingdom cannot come because there are no repentant persons who have surrendered their will and promised to Israel. There are no people yet before I came. Before he made me, before he isolated me to mountains that is temple, those in the church came, condemned them. But they were obeying the Father's will.
Yes, they were obeying the Father's will, saying, thank you. Everybody says, yes, they are obeying the Father's will. Select the meaning. They only select the will that they want them to follow. Many of them don't even want to follow us. I have not many of them. Because pastors do not present me and I want to be the son of my members. But all of your members are priests and brothers. They are all children of the devil and people. And it is true, I'm not insulting them. I am the fellow members. Now the kingdom of God has come. First, they became a wonderful member of the fallen Arabic race, who now has a kind of angry. I am passionate. Many people thought that when I preach very passionately, they thought that I am angry. You think this is because I am taking long, not being free, my mastership, because they are so slow. Love is great and love. talking of myself. The Son is the Son of the Holy Spirit. The Son will not compromise the will of the Father. Of you on this faith, and ask you on this church, the ministry of the Lord is that I have not compromised this will. The other ones. Okay? The kingdom of God is when you listen to the Son and listen to the first message. It is repentance, you listen to the will, and see to the Father now. From now on, you will be one in my life. Pray for the Almighty Father. It's now fulfilled by the kingdom of God. And the sign that Jesus comes is when his will is done here. Who is with us? Through our freedom of choice and our freedom of choice is only divine. And Simon, nobody can say that. No prayer, no persecution, no life, no death. We believe in Jesus. No hearts are fixed, no minds are made up. He will obey his will on our own. Praise the Father's name. And then, as long as you have learned about the message of repentance and his righteousness, Jesus' righteousness, everybody is his righteousness. See, it is the new righteousness, his righteousness. You live your own righteousness, his righteousness, your will. Your will is your righteousness. See, when two men fight, the Lord has an issue. Look at those denominations out there in the churches. They find a right. They all have their issues. They have their own righteousness. No, I am right. You're wrong. Let the side say, no, you're wrong. I am right. They are both right. You are both right. And they are both wrong. Very powerful righteousness. Amen. See, even in religion, there's a personal time. That's the beauty of Jesus. That's the personal time. Even the one that is speaking with the body, he will find out the divorce. He will accelerate. He will forward for you. He will stand up for you. He will write when you are not. That is God's righteousness. Any one, and of them I am right. I am writing from the other one, if you listen to the other one, you will say, no, I am writing from. It is only that that is man's righteousness, and they have carried it over to this. And you may go from, no, I am right, because I am prophesying. No, I am right, because it is easy. When you seek the kingdom of God and you found it through repentance, his righteousness, you also have found in the transfers. What is the Father's righteousness? The Father's righteousness is the will of the Father that is right. Not the Father's wants that is his will, that is his righteousness. And he is. Why is he right after all? Why would we come to Father and forget us? Why is he only right? You know why he is the only right? Because he created everything. He created it. He owns all the life. That's why he's only right. You want to be right? Become like him. Become a son. Become a daughter. When the righteousness of God, you will learn. What is that? He will give you the spirit of obedience to his will. That you will learn of his righteousness. The Father is always right. The Sister is always right. The Father is always right. Woo!
Jesus. Yes.
sure in between my legs and say, it's hard, I think. No, I did not.
The Father, Jesus, us wherever we go, because he has promised that to us, and God will find it for us, and the Spirit will be in us, and the Father, as we are finding the Holy Spirit.
Receive Christ from there. Thank you.
because the work is already finished. But please think why people's ministry. Why is the faith? Think about the reason for the certain situation here and then build a house. The glory of the other house is greater than the former. Former is the devil built in Jerusalem. The other house is the God, a promise. The ministry, Solomonic ministry. He was entrusted to build a house, build a new house, and the temple is built. Everybody was invited to come. And so we need to celebrate. Now I'm sounding the trumpet, calling on all children, come out from your stream of sin. Become children of the Lord, and as you gain the righteousness in the light of the angels, everything in the covering this is the great house of sun and waters coming from the four corners of the earth. So the command is to bring the eyes into the temple.
Thank you.
reason I am named in my Father's name. Isso não se pode dizer essa vez, sabe? Eu fui o que eu vou dizer.
Pode.
Sangue da minha tomada de Jesus. Already into the kingdom of all sorts of things. So that means where people do something in the future, to give it to us the offer of salvation. Unless we believe that through the Son, there is no obligation of salvation at all. Because it is something that is something to say, it is us. Unless it is one of us and become His heir, become a son like Him.
It's not as easy as that, even nice and easy.
that we are feeling your will, that we need financial blessings, follow his absence. Father, I see that to be on the Son, and be blessed always forever you call. His blessings, Lord, thank you. His blessings will come unto you. So, Father, we open up this next heaven for you. Thank you, Father, for the great enlightenment. Those of us that are in our position, that the man is going to come to you. Lord, glory, wherever you are, Father, we'll come unto you. And we'll embrace you and we'll bring you to the light. And we will participate in the rapture, in the life of Jesus, in the gathering, in the harvest. Thank you, Almighty Father, the Son of your children, and all the fields, the soul of the world. And give us the glory for the honor of this gift. To the precious Almighty Jesus, Almighty Father, our Lord Jesus. Blessed be the Lord. Show the blood of the Lord on fire. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next one. Thank you.